Hi guys, I'm Kasia. Welcome to the channel and welcome as always to our coffee times. Today I'm here to bring you my very last haul before the end of the year. So these are the books that I have been accumulating since my last book haul. So I thought I would show it to you guys before the year ends to see which things I treated myself with.
It's coffee time.
Before we start with the book haul, I would like to say that I'm aware that being able to spend money on books is a privilege, and I'm lucky to be able to do so. I know a lot of people are not able to do so, and there are three links that I have put on the description box down below of three really important causes that if you can do anything, even if it's just sharing the links, so try to support them. I will be really, really grateful if you could check them out. So do whatever you can. In the links, you will find information of how you can help for all of three different causes. If you can make donations, please do so. Even if it's something super small, but everything counts. And if you're unable to do so, because I know not everybody is able to make donations, please just share the links and keep fighting so that we can keep helping these three important causes that I'm going to be leaving linked down below for you guys. With that being said, it's time to talk books, you guys. So most of the books I'm gonna be showing you are either horror or thriller books. And yeah, so if you love horror and if you love books, you are in the right place. So if you're not one of the members of the coffee family, just click the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell so you don't miss any more coffee times. So the first thing that I've purchased is actually a bookmark. Now, I don't really buy too many bookmarks, but when I saw this one, I knew it had to be mine. And it is this cute unicorn that is reading books, and it says, "Sorry, my night is all booked." The next thing is a graphic novel. It's the only one that I have purchased lately, and that is Lock and Key Volume 4. I am collecting these ones. I'm buying them secondhand because I'm buying the hardcover editions and they're really pricey, so I'm getting all of these ones secondhand. But I am currently reading them so I can watch the show, so I decided to pick up volume 4 so that we can at some point check the show. Next, let's talk about a couple of new releases that I have picked up. The first one is Plain Bad Heroines by Emily M. Danforth. And I picked this one up because it just sounded so good, and it is supposed to be horror combined with a little bit of comedy. We follow a boarding school for girls in New England at the beginning of the 1900s, and something happened there with some of the girls, and then we skip forward a whole century, and apparently there is a film crew that is doing a movie in that school, and something happens, or the lines between the past and the present kind of cross. I'm not really sure, but it sounded like just amazing to me. So I'm really excited to pick this one up next year. Next we have The Once and Future Witches by Alex E. Harrow. So last year I read 10,000 Doors of January and I really enjoyed it. At the beginning it was very slow paced and I was scared I was not gonna like it, but then, you know, I really got invested in the characters and the plot and I loved it so much. I appreciated the story a lot and the writing was so beautiful and you just really got immersed in that world. So when the author came up with a book about witches, I was like, yes please. And all I know is that it follows a couple of different girls, that it has to do with witches and New Salem and the feeling of sisterhood. So I'm just super excited for this one. Also, you guys, today I am filming during daylight, and so if you see the light changing, I'm so sorry, but the sun is hitting my window right now and it is a little bit challenging to keep the lighting consistent, so I'm sorry for that. So next, I finally got myself a copy of The Whisper Man by Alex North. This is the story of Tom that, after losing his wife suddenly, he decides to take his son and move into a new town looking for a fresh start, a new beginning. But in that town, 20 years ago, there was a serial killer that abducted 5 people, and his modus operandi was whispering to the people through their windows at night. So that's all I know, and I'm excited because it just sounds like a nice thriller with splashes of horror, and I hope I'm gonna love it. The next book doesn't need any introduction because that is Home Before Dark by Riley Sager. At this point, you guys know it's become an autobiography author for me, and I have been waiting all year to treat myself to this copy. And this story is about Maggie. So when she was a kid, she and her dad were in this kind of like Victorian mansion, and his father wrote a book about how he had encounters there with certain ghosts and weird things happen in that place. So 25 years later, after her father passes away, Maggie inherits this mansion, and she kind of always thought that the things his father wrote were not true, but maybe being back now in that house, it's going to change her mind. Next one is a fantasy book, but there is a reason why I chose this book, and that is Deathless Girls by Kieran Millwood Hargrave. So I picked this one up because this is kind of like a retelling of, not really of Dracula, but it's telling the story of his brides. And I thought that was so interesting because anything that it's like a retelling or something related to Dracula or Vlad Tepes, it's something that I would like to read about. And so I decided to pick this one up, and I'm hoping to love it. And the last hardcover that I have to show you, it's another release from 2020, and that is The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab. So I have been meaning to pick up this book. I know there's a lot of hype currently around the book, so I also kind of wanted to wait until next year when the hype goes down a little bit to read it myself. But anything that V.E. Schwab puts out there, I'm automatically interested. There's something about her writing and her characters that always has captivated me. Some of her books I have enjoyed more or less, but in general I enjoy her writing, and I've heard amazing things about this book. All I know is that it's about this woman that I believe at the beginning of the 1700s makes a pact to kind of live forever, and she doesn't know exactly what she's, you know, doing. She probably was a little bit naive about making that pact, and I guess we follow her through time. That is all that I remember from the book, but like I said, I really just love V.E. Schwab's writing, so I'm hoping to really love it. So originally I was gonna order the regular black cover, but then I found this edition, and I'm not sure if it's a UK exclusive, but it is so pretty, you guys. Look at the end pages and look at the naked book. It's just so pretty. The next book is a present from one of my favorite booktubers, one of the first booktubers that I started kind of having a friendship with when I started my own channel, and that is Olivia Savannah over at Olivia's Catastrophe. I'm gonna leave her channel linked down below so you can check it out and give her some support and subscribe to her. So she sent me an early Christmas present, and she sent me Little Fires Every Way by Celeste NG. I don't know how you pronounce that surname, but this is a thriller that I have been meaning to pick up also for the longest time because I really, really want to check out the show. I'm somebody that I love movies, I love TV shows, and sometimes I will pick up books because I really want to check the TV show or the movie. So I'm super happy to have a copy now. I have heard really, really good things about this, actually not about this one, but also other books by the same author. If I remember correctly, this is about a mother that moves into a town and sends her kids to school there, and she starts a relationship with the other moms there, but there's like really dark secrets or things that start coming out, something like that. Sorry, it was a little bit vague, but that is all that I remember about it. So yeah, thank you so much, Olivia, for sending this my way. It was so sweet. It was such a surprise that day. I was not expecting to get any book that day, and then this beautiful thing showed up. So thank you so much, and it's definitely going into my TBR pile for 2021. The next book, I think it's a paranormal story, and I don't know who, but somebody recommended this to me, and I found it like new secondhand, so I had to pick it up, and that is Last Call at the Nightshade Lunch by Paul Kruger. It says a novel of magic and mixology. I don't know, but it looked cute. And I haven't read paranormal in so long that I thought, you know, it would be good to pick it up since I have heard good things about it and it was recommended to me. So I hope to have time to pick it up like sometime next year. I feel like lately I've been picking up a lot of books that were recommended to me, and you know, I like to do that because some of the people that recommend books to me are people that either know me or have been following me for a while, so they probably know the things that I like. And the next book was recommended to me by two different people. One is Ola and the other one is Kayla over at Crack Into a Good Book, so I had to pick it up, and that is The Hollow Places by T. Kingfisher. I picked this one up hoping to love it because it's horror combined with humor, like with comedy, and those tend to be tricky sometimes because it depends on the type of humor and if it's something for you or not. But I've heard really good things about the author in general, about the other book called The Twisted Ones, I think it was called. So yeah, I also want to give this one a try. The next book is the first book on a zombie series, and I think a subscriber recommended this to me if I remember correctly, and the book is Dead City by Joe McKinney. So I picked the first book and I picked it up actually secondhand, but it looks like new, and I'm really excited about this one because I have not been picking up many new books about zombies, and it is a genre that I enjoy, even though it has been a little bit overdone in the last couple of years after the whole Walking Dead thing happened. But I still, you know, would like to read about zombies because I really enjoy the story, so I hope that I'm gonna enjoy this series. Moving on to more secondhand books that I found, and these are two paperbacks from Christopher Pike that I was able to grab. The first one is Weekend. All I know about this one is A Trip to Mexico Turns Deadly, something we like. And the next one is about a serial killer, The Cold One, another thing that we like. And also the cover of this one is just so cute. I mean, just look at this cover, it's just so pretty. The next secondhand book that I picked up is another Richard Layman book from my collection, and that's called Night in the Lonesome October. It is about a guy that has just discovered that the girlfriend is in love with somebody else. I mean, the drama. So he goes out for a walk in October, and apparently that walk turns into probably a survival kind of night. Maybe something is hunting him, I don't know, but it sounds like a lot of fun. Richard Layman style, so yeah, I'm excited about this one as well. Actually, you guys, I forgot I have another secondhand book by Christopher Pike. So I've been trying to catch up with my horror collection. I'm trying to find more books secondhand. It's not so easy here in Germany to find them in English, but I'm trying. So I decided to start collecting the Spookville series by Christopher Pike. So I grabbed the first book, which is this beautiful book here. It's The Secret Path. And it's the first book in the series, so I'm hoping to be able to slowly but surely collect the whole series. And now I have a couple of middle grade books to show you. So one of my plans was for next year to read more spooky middle grade books, so I have ordered a couple. But apart from those spooky books, I ended up finally ordering a copy of Nevermore by Jessica Townsend. This is the first book, and I have heard this is a beautiful magic world, and people said it reminded them of, you know, the one that shall not be named because it's been written by an author that we are no longer supporting. But because they said it was similar to that, I was already interested, and lately I have been seeing so many people reading it and hyping it up that I gave in and I finally ordered the first book. So now let's go to those spooky middle grades. I ended up ordering three to start, and the first one is actually a book that I think a subscriber also mentioned to me that I should check out these series, and it is from the series Creep Over. So the first book, it's called Truth or Dare, and as the title says, it has to do with a game of truth or dare. The covers of this series are so cute. I really, really like them. So I'm hoping to enjoy the books as well. Then I picked up one that I have seen a couple of people mentioning lately, saying that it was so good and it didn't read like too middle grade, like it was really spooky. So I'm like, okay, I'm here for it. And that is The Mystery of Black Hollow Lane by Julia Noble. And this is about a kid that after the dad goes missing, she is sent to a boarding school because the mother cannot be bothered to take care of her own kid. Great parenting right there. But while she's in this boarding school, she finds a box that used to belong to her father. And I guess that sends her kind of like in a journey. So I'm here to see that. And the next one is one that I've heard also amazing things about. It's called The Hunting of Abilene Jones by Phil Hikes. And this one, it's about a girl that has always been reading about ghost stories until one day she finds a really mysterious book. Yeah, that's all I know, but these three are the new spooky middle grades that I have picked up. So if you've read any of these, let me know down below. If you have more spooky middle grade book recommendations, let me know down below, because like I said, next year I want to catch up a little bit with spooky middle grades. They are the perfect read for like in between, like really heavy topic, like adult horror, or sometimes you're in a reading slump, you need something that it's a bit shorter, easy to read, to get you going. They might also be perfect for like 24-hour readathons because they are kind of short. So yeah, all recommendations that you have, leave them down below. Alright you guys, so these are all the books that I have been hoarding for the last couple of weeks. I hope that you enjoyed these, kind of a messy book haul. I'm so sorry, I don't know what's up today, but today is just not my day. We all have those days, so I'm sorry if this video is a little bit all over the place. So sorry, I just wanted to show you before the year ends the books that I have been purchasing before the end of 2020. Let me know down below, have you been getting any books? What are the books that you want to get for Christmas that are on your Christmas wish list? Let's talk about books down below in the comments. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. Please give the video a big thumbs up for support. And also, if you want to follow me, you know, the social media, the links to my Twitter, my Instagram, everything is in the description box down below. And I hope to see you all in the next coffee time. Bye.